Malo Edele, welcome back to Tangata Pasifika. Well, as we saw in our story before the break, Tongan Language Week is on this coming week, and within the halls of power in Cabinet, there are two ministers of Tongan descent. Very exciting for representation for our Tongan women. Alongside Kamau Sipuloni is Jenny Salesa, and Minister Salesa joins us for our Talanoa today. Thank you for coming on the program. Proudly in Tongan, mate ma'a Tonga red as well, I must say.
That's right, maloela mali, pea maloela le ke pongpongin.
So, the upcoming Tongan Language Week, obviously a highlight for this year for you. Is there any highlights within the diary that you're looking forward to meeting with the community?
Absolutely. So this Sunday we're going to have a celebration of Tongan Language Week in Parliament, where a number of different choirs from the Wellington region are going to come in and we'll celebrate together with myself, the Minister of Pacific Peoples, Aupito Suobulimsio, and Anahila Kanangata Aswiswiki, and many others.
It's going to be exciting. Looking at some of the other work that you've been doing recently, we had in our news about this new system that you've launched, micro-credential system to help with the skills shortage. If I was a young person wanting to say, upskill or get a job, can you just tell me how advantageous it would be, especially for our Pacific community?
Sure. So micro-credentialing is a new system that NZQA has allowed us to do here in Aotearoa for the first time. What it allows our young people to do is, instead of, say, planning and looking forward to going into either a polytechnic or university to study for a whole year, micro-credentialing allows you to chunk your learning up into smaller bits. So you can do a course for, say, 12 weeks, and the credentialing system can be as little as 5 credits or up to 40 credits instead of, say, 60 to 100 credits. So, for instance, if you're wanting to learn how to do framing, you can actually do that within 3 months. You can actually work full-time and do micro-credentialing course in the evenings. You can learn other bits of how to build a house. And you know, we're looking at doing more prefabricated building of houses. You know, we're already doing quite a lot of that already. It's more attractive for our young people because they don't have to look forward to taking a long time out to train. They can chunk it up.
And do you see this qualification system also helping to build more houses?
Absolutely. What we know from building houses traditionally is it takes between 18 months and sometimes over 2 years to build one bespoke house. Prefabricated houses we can build within 4 to 6 weeks, and in some cases up to 8 weeks, and it takes one qualified person and a few semi-skilled people. So we really look forward, not just for Pacific, but to attract more women into building and construction and to attract more Māori people as well.
So it takes a short amount of time to make these houses prefabricated, seems like the go, but how affordable are they really going to be, for especially for our community?
So, as you know, we've announced the Kiwi Build houses, right? So Kiwi Build houses is one of those steps to getting more people into home ownership.
It's still expensive though, $650,000 for a 3-bedroom home.
It is.
How many of our people can actually get into them?
So we are working actually now on a different way to address both Māori home ownership and Pacific home ownership.
Can you tell us a bit more about an initiative that's in the pipeline?
It's being, the policy is being developed now. So we're looking at things like, for instance, equity share of home ownership, where instead of looking just at two people earning and then getting a loan from a bank, getting hopefully 3, 4, as you know, our families live in, you know, many of us live together in the one house. I can tell you that when I actually first got into home ownership, I got into home ownership together with my parents and one of my brothers. And so at the time, this is way back in the 90s, banks actually allowed us to go into home ownership. It was for 4 different people. So we as a government, as you know, we're not a bank, but we're looking at what are the ways of ensuring that home ownership can be accessible to people, including Pacific home ownership. As you know, in the 1980s, about 50% of our people either owned their own home or lived in a home that their relative owned. But that home ownership has really decreased to, I think it's only 16% now, according to the last stats.
Absolutely. Yes. Well, almost to the end of our chat for today, and I'm sure we're going to talk more about housing in the future as well, but Tongan Language Week, is there something that you want to say, especially to our Tongan community?
I'd like to encourage all of our people at home, our grandparents, our parents as well, to keep talking in Tongan to our children. Whakakoloa o Aotearoa Aki Ofofonua is the language theme for Tongan Language Week this week, and I look forward to celebrating Tongan language the whole week, and indeed the whole year. We are going to do some special celebrations in Parliament ourselves as MPs.
Mālo, Aupito. Thank you, Jenny, for coming on the show.
Mālo.